Alright, alright. So, I'm sitting here, and you can see I've got this right in front of me. Can you see the very top of it anyway? It's an old tiller, and an old Craftsman, 5 horsepower. And, you know, I picked this up. I actually got it when I was picking up actually a tractor, which I'll show in a later video. It's pretty cool. And while I was there, the guy said, man, do you want this? Just take it if you want it, right? And I almost didn't, because it looks like it's in pretty bad shape. But it just so happens I actually need one. I've fixed all these tillers over the years and have never kept one, and have really never had any use for them. But in this case, it's like, well, I could use a tiller for one little project. I have some mounds of dirt and stuff that it would be easier if I had a tiller to break it all up, and then I can spread it out. And I'm trying to level off this piece of land. Let me show you. So I've been clearing all this off, and you see this lump here and back here. It used to be remnants of a garden, but it's gardens grow. I don't have a green thumb, and everybody else gave up on it. So I'm going to level all this up. And you can see I removed the canopy that was covering this Suzuki, and I'm putting up another 10 by 20 tent, kind of like these, but a lot more to it, but we'll see once we get there. I need to level all this off. Here's a lump, there's a lump, there's a lump. And as I spread it out, I know there's some low spots around here that yeah, look at all this stuff I had to move. I barely have room to walk around. But that's what I'll be using this 10 by 20 for. At least I can put some stuff away and actually have a place to work on stuff. But that's coming. So I decided I'm gonna see if I can't get this tiller working. And you can see, here's the pull rope, and it's missing the pull rope assembly. And I thought I had one back over here, because I can see the motor right there. But I think it was a 3.5 horse, and this one I'm looking for is a 5, and up here. So I looked at all my parts, and nothing would fit. So I'll probably just use my hand drill or something and rotate it that way to get it started. But you can see it's just, there's bolts missing and everything's just rusted away. But if I can get it running enough to finish my little project, then I'll be happy. So let's see what we can do. So do you hear that? Coming from back there somewhere, I have no idea what that is. Weird stuff coming from this side, and somebody's getting a new roof on the other side. So plenty of noise today. Well, let's give this thing a look over here. Yikes. Boy, that stinks. Man, I don't know if this one's going to be worth it. Well, it's got oil in it. Well, take a look at the air cleaner and carburetor. Cobwebs. all rusty in there. This one looks like it's going to be a challenge. Well, it turns. Well, I'm going to see if I can't get some carburetor cleaner down into the carb. Do it the old-fashioned way. Probably what that guy was doing. Ah. That just sprayed me in my face. Alright, I'm going to put this cover back on so that it won't spray me in the face again. Turning it the right way. I'd like to see if we're getting spark too, huh? Alright, well, let's check for spark. Well, it's getting gas in there. Somewhere where I can see it. Yeah, plenty of spark. That's cool. So I'm going to spray some two-cycle oil directly in it. Just hand tighten it. Let's see if we can get it to give us a okay, I gotta figure something else out. Alright, let's see if I can get this drill going. Man, this is an old Sears Craftsman. I haven't used this in ages. Just your basic 3/8 inch drill. Nope, it tried. awesome. Well, so the question is, I know that is some stinking gas in here, so I need to get the gas out of here and see if we can get it flowing through this old carburetor. But I actually have some carburetors, so let's see if we can get this old gas out of it. Alright, so I got about half a tank in there. I sprayed some of it down in there, but you know what? I think I should put this back on and put the cover back on so it doesn't spray gas in my face again. That wasn't too nice. Okay, so the choke is on. It's about half throttle. Holy shit, who would have guessed? I almost gave up on this thing, you know? So, fuck, it's cranking. Unbelievable, huh? Guess I can put all this stuff back on and, you know, I just wanted it for this one little project I'm gonna do. But hey, it might be worth restoring if it actually started that easy. So I guess the rest of it, it's running. I just want to make sure free everything up here and make sure the tillers are turning. Yeah, I'm blown away, man. So it's working, and I might just have to get it good and cleaned up, find a new housing here for the pull rope, and just clean it up, you know. And I know there's some bolts missing. Yeah, see under here? That one's loose. There's only one on this side. This little, isn't there a, yeah, this looks like it's all banged up, down here at the bottom, where it has that little bar that comes down, so you can control the depth of your, how deep you're cutting through the tines, and, what else, yeah, cables are free. I guess that is to engage the belt there. Wow.
Wow, so yeah, that blows me away. I was not expecting it to start that easy. It was just a matter of getting the flywheel to turn, you know. At first I tried the pull rope, that wasn't enough. But after I adapted that the drill with the socket on it, man, it just cranks right up. Just dumped the old gas and that was it. Put some fresh stuff in it and it's cranking right up. The little tines are turning well. I just need to clean up. Looks like, I don't know if that's rope or, yeah, some rope and some just weeds and stuff. So, yeah, so I might end up having to keep this one. It looks bad enough where I wouldn't want to sell it off to anybody. But after I clean it up, and I know I have some parts, I have a couple of old tillers out there, I could probably rob it from parts and all that good stuff. So, oh well, I get surprised every day. It's running, that means I have some work to do. So, yeah, so, well, thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and watch for my next video.